Good afternoon, Eagles. Today is October 3rd. I'm Lily Kreitzer.
And I'm Josh Lee. Let's get into your announcements.
Today is National Techies Day. Also, this day in history, in 1955, the Guinness Book of World Records debuts.
Show off your spirit and participate in each day's theme. Tomorrow's theme is class colors. Freshmen wear white, sophomores wear yellow, juniors wear purple, and seniors wear black.
Powder Puff is tonight, right after the homecoming parade. Come watch the juniors beat the seniors.
No, come watch the seniors win. Be there.
Women in STEM will have their first meeting today after school at room 242. We look forward to seeing you there.
The jazz band is selling crumble cookies again in the commons while supplies last. There are four options this week: chocolate chip, cookies and cream, pumpkin cake, and oatmeal chocolate chip. Cookie sales will be 1 to 3 p.m. by the old auditorium.
Are you an ally or a member of the LGBTQ community? Would you like to help make AHS an even more welcoming place for all? Our first club meeting will be Tuesday, October 8th from 245 to 330 in room 218. Snacks will be provided. Hope to see you there.
We will be on a midday assembly schedule tomorrow. Make sure you know the bell schedule, especially for those with a release.
Hi, Eagles. I just wanted to give a quick shout out to our early learning speed strength students that helped set up for our college and career fairs today, and also to our custodial staff. You guys did an amazing job. Thank you so much.
Tell me a little bit about your scholarships.
So at the Community Foundation of Lorain County, we have 62 scholarship funds. We offer them to students throughout Lorain County. Some of our scholarship funds are like district specific, major specific, but mostly we help Lorain County students achieve higher education, whether that's through a traditional two-year, four-year college, or through the trades.
Tell me a little about this.
So we work in law enforcement, obviously, in my uniform. You can apply to be a police officer base. Essentially 20. You just need to be old enough to carry a firearm. So that's the reason for the age limit. By the time you graduate the academy, it's 21. Essentially just an interest. Everyone knows what the police do, you know what we do. As long as you have somewhat of an interest, you can speak to one of us. And once you go to the academy, it's from there on, you can go into any sort of specialty. That's what we're here for, kind of showing all the different jobs within our job that you can do. But you can go to school first. That's what I did. Before you go to the academy, you don't have to just wait to go to the academy for those 3 years of waiting and roll on into a job. So,
tell me a little bit about nursing.
Well, right now there is a nursing shortage, a critical nursing shortage. So you can get into the nursing field in 2 years as a registered nurse through LC. By taking some prereqs in high school, you can go directly into the program in the fall. And the average salary is about $68,000 to $72,000 a year with multiple sign-on bonuses, tuition reimbursement, loan forgiveness, things like that will help you pay for then to go to your next degree, which would be your bachelor's degree.
And now for sports.
The boys soccer team defeated the Amherst Steel Comets with a score of 2-0. Two goals from Ben Sather with assists from Gabe Kitchens and Owen Warg, as well as an impressive defensive performance by Frankie Kenny, Logan Fitchko, Kyle Hallowell, Owen Warg, Mark Duche, Wesley Shea, Colton Fitch, and Finn Petzinger, only giving up one shot all game, led the Eagles to an SWC win. Congrats, boys. The girls' volleyball team will travel to take on the Midview Middies in an SWC matchup today at 6 p.m. Good luck, ladies.
And now for your daily TikTok.
That's all we have for you today, Eagles. I'm Josh Lee.
And I'm Lily Kreitzer. See you at the homecoming parade tonight.